Okay, I'm going to give everyone a T-minus 30. We'll get started momentarily. All right, can everyone please join me for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you, everyone. Before we get started, I'm going to request a moment of silence for Charles Dix, who many of us know, and for many years he generously donated Christmas trees to the community, which he sold from city-owned property on North Main Street for many years, and he passed away after a lengthy illness. So if folks would join me for a moment of silence. Thank you. All right, and it looks like we're going to take the field with everybody except Councilmember Sanchez, who I do expect to be here at some point. I do see where he has some proclamations. Wayne, do you see is Sergio en route? Okay. Well, we'll see if we can. Steve, can you take a look at those since that's kind of near your neck of the woods, the Nativity Creek Park First Annual? Is there a group here from the, okay. All right, you know what, why don't we, with your permission, we'll have Councilmember Villegas see if he can do an imitation of Councilmember Sanchez.
Hard, really hard.
All right, and then, why don't we start with, if you'd like to, just come to the podium and let everyone know about the project, and then Steve will do the recognizing. Does that work?
No pressure.
You can do this, Steve. I know you can.
Not only is Councilmember Sanchez absent, but so is the chair and founder of the Music and Arts Summit. But I'll go ahead and just, this year was our first annual, our inaugural event for the Salinas Music and Arts Summit. It was a two-day event. The first date was held on July 11th, the second on August 8th at Natividad Creek Park. We had two stages with over 20 bands and performances on July 11th and over 24 on August 8th. A combination of local professional bands, youth dancers, youth musicians, and youth theater and arts performances. Major sponsors, thank you so much, is Artie Fields. Artie's missing in action. During these tough economic times, it's so important for us to partner with eight local agencies, and the City of Salinas Parks and Rec came in and was a major sponsor. So we would not have been able to put this event out without the support of the city. So I want to personally thank Artie Fields. Thank you, Artie. Major sponsor, we had the Arts Council, LSL Eagles, a lot of the community organizations like Salvation Army. Let's see, we had over 60 volunteers from LSL High, LSL Eagles, Return of the Natives, and Music and Arts Committee members, families, and friends. Total number of individuals that came to the two-day event throughout the event was over 1,000 people. So it was a total grassroots event. We could not have done it without, some of our committee members are here, Venetia Devon Evans, who's with Youth Music Monterey. Vanessa Garcia is also here. But it was really important for us as a committee to make sure that we recognize our volunteers. LSL Eagles put in an enormous amount of time putting this event on, the actual labor intensive work that, I mean, it was just, we did two park cleanups also. So again, LSL Eagles, some of the board, their board members are being recognized today. So I thank Sergio Sanchez, he actually attended, and a couple other, I think another council member attended the event. So we're really, thank you for your support and especially for the recognition. Thank you so much.
Good, thank you. Okay, Steve, if you'll call out. call out the names. We'll have them run the gauntlet.
Okay. And on, again, on behalf of the Salinas City Council, we commend and congratulate the following people for their committee volunteer work for the 2010 Salinas Music and Arts Summit for their outstanding commitment and service to the Salinas community. Thank you once again. So I'll call the following names, and if you're here, please come on up and start with Councilmember Barrera there, and we'll congratulate you. Raul Garnica. Come on up. Ray Lerma. Ray Lerma. Okay. Belen Tamayo. Javier Tamayo. Carmen Orduño.
Congratulations, thank you.
Daniel Ramirez. Roy Madrigal. Roy's here. Come on up, Roy. Linda Gavino. No Linda. Frank Guevara. Ryan Christopher Contreras. Steve Sloop. Sylvester Duvon. Robert Bauer. And Nathalia Carrillo. Come on up, Nathalia. Last, Rafael Garcia, are you here? All right, always saving the best for last. Come on up, please.
How are you? Good to see you. All right, next up, I'm going to do a proclamation on National Assisted Living Week. Jenny, why don't you come up to the podium? I'll do that, and then I'll have you talk a bit, and then get to take home your prize.
Thank you.
All right. Whereas the number of elderly and disabled Americans is dramatically increasing, and whereas assisted living is a long-term care service that fosters choice, dignity, independence, and autonomy in our elderly nationwide, and whereas the National Center for Assisted Living proudly created National Assisted Living Week, and whereas the theme of National Assisted Living Week 2010, Living Life, highlights the opportunity to share with our residents a multitude of events and activities that will place an emphasis on promoting brain healthy activities that optimize mental and physical health in order to live life to the fullest. Now, therefore, I, Dennis Donahue, Mayor of Salinas, do hereby proclaim the week of September 12 through 18, 2010, as National Assisted Living Week in Salinas, California. I urge all citizens to visit friends and loved ones who reside at these facilities, and also to learn more about assisted living services and how they benefit our communities. And that's dated the ninth day of September, 2010. So I'm happy to present this to you after
you.
A few comments about your week.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mayor Donahue, for this opportunity to accept the proclamation that you have just issued. We are part of the assisted living program throughout the nation. We are an assisted living memory care community located in Salinas. Our focus is on our elderly population. Our motto is, our family is committed to yours, and we're very serious about doing this. Our new theme for the year really does have to do with brain health, and there's a multitude of things that we can do to make our brain healthy, and we're capturing many of those this week. So if you have the time, we'd love for you to come and visit us and learn more about Thank you very much.
Very good. Come on up and get this, and we'll... isn't it?
Yes, it is. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Okay, and any resemblance to Jenny and Debbie Hale is coincidental just by virtue of the fact she's her mom. Other than that, there is no connection. And so, that's Debbie Hale's mom. Who knew? I know. How about that? Like Debbie, Jenny does good work. All right, with that, we are going to... I will first of all apologize ahead of time as the host of this evening's events. I'm fighting a cough. I'll do the best I can to, as my wife would say if she were here, Dennis, don't cough into the microphone. So I will try. But she has done her job. I hear her even though she's not. Public comment. We have an interesting item on the agenda, and so sometimes when that happens, we get folks who might be visiting us for the first time. We're not sure we always send everyone away happy, but we always want to be good hosts. So a couple things. Public comment is limited to those items not on the agenda. So if you're here to talk about in code enforcement, that'll come up later. Public comment, as will items on the agenda, is limited to 2 minutes. It's pretty darn strictly enforced, and the reason I say it like that is if you're a really adept student of the English language and know how to do run-on sentences and commas, and I've got two school teachers up here to help me out, if I catch you with an actual sentence after 2 minutes, you're done. If, however, on the other hand, you are extremely good at punctuation and are finishing a thought, we want to let you do that. So those are kind of the ground rules, and with that, public comment is now open for business for all items not on the agenda. Not on the agenda.
Once again, we finished praying for the unborn, for the end of abortion. We pray every Tuesday from 2:30 to 3:30 in front of Planned Parenthood. Mother Teresa said that the greatest destroyer of peace is abortion, because if a mother can kill her own child, then what is it for me to kill you or you to kill me? The paper today and the news is filled with more violence in this city. And some of that cannot be stopped, at least immediately. But the leadership of the city, this leadership, it has it wrong. They don't start with trying to end abortion, working to make it tougher for Planned Parenthood to murder innocent children. And they don't work to execute those who wantonly are leading the gangs, putting out the hits from prison. These are guys even in federal prison who are supposed to be completely isolated. I've talked with the mayor many times, and those who are guilty, have been found guilty in a court of law, they need to be executed swiftly to help end violence on that. And the mayor and the city council need to promote the defense of the unborn. If we get our priorities straight, violence will significantly go down to a more manageable level, and we will have a great city again.
Okay, thank you. Next.
Mayor, I wonder if I could. This is a front page from ICLEI, in which the city is contracted with. If I can put that on the screen, please.
It's going to cut into your 2 minutes while we do it all.
Well, I'll start right now. I'm talking about city policy. The newspapers are in concert with the city, converting self-government to United Nations-directed administration. The city is violating Article 1, Section 10 by contracting with the UN and its partner.